diaphragm pressing down the liver, spleen, blah blah blah, pressing down the intestine, and everything is pressing down where? Perineum. So the perineum, the concept is between the gate between life and death, because if you're broken, you die immediately. You're broken, internal organ go out, you die immediately. This is what they call hernia. You know, hernia is something like when some texture break the intestine come out. Someone know, I mean, I don't know in Thai language how to call. Okay, this kind of problem. This kind of problem is because your tendon, your fascia, you know, tendon like a shirt, like a fascia, like this. You never training, they are not strong enough, the gravity pull down, and one day you carry something and you do, broom. They broken, the intestine a little bit go out, you have to go to the hospital, they open it, and nowadays they put a kind of plastic thing inside and they close it again. So, to don't arrive to that point, you should train your body. If you train your body, everything is, this is what we call internal pratic. I mean, this one, like you see, this is external pratic, okay? This is muscle. But this we talk about tendon. So when you're training this part, you will never have that problem, okay? So this we talk about the body part, why we hit that. To stimulate that point, to make it strong. And this is very, very important, but people don't know. That's why I'm here. Yes. Surprise. Okay? Now, if we talk about energetically, I think most of you, they know, they listen by the yogi, they talk about chakra, right? Chakra, chakra, everything is chakra for India people. Okay, so where they are this chakra? Where? Chakra, sorry, chakra. Where they are this point? Okay, they are somewhere in the body, but they are based on what? They are based on one line that go through exactly your body from the top of the crown to the perineum. Surprise! So, from this line, from the perineum to the top of the crown, if you draw the line, on this line they are positioning the famous chakra. And this is the line by the gravity straight into the ground, to the center of the earth, and up for the spiritual pratic and technique, up where? To the universe. And where? To God. So when you pray or meditate, what you do? You go up this way, you go down this way, and then you are in the middle. Okay, so as you see, the perineum is this is very, very important. So now you understand, now you can eat the perineum. Okay, we got the back. So we hit the back. Oh, I you have to learn how to use this one and hit all chakra. All. Completely all. Now, after this one, we go up to the lower back. Eat your lower back. Eat, when you eat your lower back, it will help you for many, many things. For example, most of the people like you in Bangkok live on the chair. BTS, metro, office, car, McDonald's. I'm sure everyone go there. And everything. So you are always sitting. So one of the problems, especially for the people in the big city like Bangkok and everywhere in the world, is back pain. How you can get rid of back pain? Medicine? No. Yesterday, I see one building in back of somewhere, and have this huge picture of this guy like this. I think it was an hospital anyway. So they was promoting, maybe someone see, no? They was promoting that they can solve your back pain. But how they can solve your back pain? That's the question. Do you ever think about that? Your back pain, the name is your back pain, is not the back pain of the doctor. So what doctor do is, I give you medicine. The medicine that they give you is analgesic. Mean terminology, they shut down the system in your mind to feel the pain. It's like a paracetamol. So you take it, oh, it's fantastic. I don't feel nothing anymore. Look at that. I was with, so the doctor said, it's okay, it's finished, but when you get it again, you just take another pills. It's easy, no? Actually, you still have the back pain. What you have to do is just take one pill every time you feel it. So then you don't feel it, but you still have it. When you have back pain, mean that something is going wrong in the area. And in passing the time, it will be broken more and more and more. So in the end, what's happened? Many people, they go to have a surgery because the soft bone between the strong bone, the spine, you know, they just smash each other. You don't have any more. You cannot move anymore. So what they do now? They open. One people pull from the leg. One people pull from the arm. Anyone? Oops! I put in the middle the fake soft disc now, and it's done. Bangkok Hospital, 350,000 baht. Finished. Easy, no? So, you can solve the problem. Again, this is magic. It's magic. Why? Because beating yourself, you generate vibration. Okay, you don't have to do all this, but it's very important to do. The vibration that give you life. Because life force, in the end of the day, is vibration. Okay, so, upper back. If you cannot arrive, ask the friend to beat yourself,
you
know?
You can help your friend.
So find a partner, the partner beat.
Oh, okay. So you have a partner, and you...
Yeah, when I teach in China, we do the train, you know? All the classes are just a long train, and everyone beat. Spend time. Now, when you have this, you can arrive, but later. When you don't have it...
Okay, we have to take a partner, and then we alternate.
Don't turn before the guy stops. If not, you get in the face. Okay? Oh, this is nice. Okay. We got it? Okay, you can keep it to the train. It's okay, fair enough. Now we go to shoulder. So your friend can hit your shoulder. Hit your shoulder. Keep smiling, that's important. Try to make your friend not smile anymore, it's hard. Then we go base of the neck. Base of the neck. You can use the end as a knife. Bam, bam, bam. Now from the base of the neck, you go to your skull. All around. This some the microphone fly away. So after that, top of the crown. Now, top of the crown is very important. This is what we said before. Top of the crown is connected to the perineum. And this, your highest spiritual point that you have, and is the only, let's say, the one way out to the heaven. So,
how do you feel now? Do you feel more energized? Feel more lively? Or you feel more tired? Okay, is everyone here? Can I start? Okay, Am I speaking too fast?
No.
Okay. My initial lecture was supposed to be Taoist sexual practice, a journey from healing to enlightenment. But now it's a secret of longevity. Okay, so actually that's the same thing. And we will go through the lecture to understand why it's sexual energy related to longevity. You know, when you're talking about a secret of longevity, when you interview like old people who are like 100 years old, and ask them why they live that long, and then they'll say, oh, they eat this, they eat that, they have good family, they have good, you know, relationship, you know. It's kind of boring, right? So today we hear about secret of longevity with a sexual twist. Sexual twist. No, twist. Okay, the Taoists were not, actually, the Taoists were not looking for longevity. They were looking for immortality. And then you wonder, why am I talking about immortality in a palliative care workshop, right? Okay, the thing is that first we have to understand what immortality is. Okay, everyone is looking at this at this slide, right? This is actually the painting in the cave of a Taoist practice that they discover. This is supposed to be the human body. So they symbolize different parts of the human body, because the whole practice is to reverse the flow of water, which means to reverse the aging process. I won't describe this because it takes a long time. But anyway, let's talk about mortality. Like, you know, physical dying is inevitable. We all have to leave the body at one point. Let's say for people who are taking care of people who are sick, people who are dying, it's our attitude that's very important. Because sometimes when we always think we don't die, we think the other person are dying, right? So sometimes you feel sorry for them. Or let's say when you hear like your friend has cancer or something, and you want to say something nice, but sometimes what you say makes them more unhappy. Because it's not what you say, it's not the right word, it's your own attitude towards dying. If you have good attitude towards dying, you understand it's part of life, that you will die too, and you have optimistic view of dying. When you talk to people, you know, who are dying or people who are sick, you add whatever you say, it will make them feel good. It's your attitude. I can say this because I had cancer, and there's so many friends who are trying to do many different things. Sometimes it's very offending what they say because they're so frightened of death themselves. So things they say makes you feel uncomfortable because it's their feeling. Meanwhile, other friends I have a friend whose mother just died of cancer, and she was nursing her mother for a year. So whenever she talked to me, whatever she did, it was very comforting because she has very understanding of dying. She has a good sense of, you know, something that we all have to go through, but there's always a way to deal with it. It's also there's always this optimistic part of dying, or even like we don't really know if someone's going to die or not. Maybe that person might my heel.